Hey folks, Matt from ArtOfTheImage.com. With the M50 on its way, and I'm really looking forward to getting that camera in, we've got yet another addition to the M series. Canon is getting serious about the mirrorless lineup. They're expanding it. The new M50 is, I would argue, the best M series camera they've put out yet, the most full featured anyways. But it begs the question, where is the lineup going? How expanded is the lineup going to be? How many DSLRs are we going to have left in the lineup at the end? And I was thinking about this and looking at this and trying to figure out, based on what Canon's traditional DSLR lineup has always been, where they've decided to have various price points with various features, and flush that out to or extrapolate that to an M-series lineup, what we could expect to see. Currently, we have the M100. That was announced August 29th of 2017. It's currently at 549 list on the Canon USA website for the kit. So that's with the lens. We've got the M50. That's brand new. It was just announced. That's $899 with the kit. We've got the M3. That's getting old. That was February 6, 2015. $799 kit price is what it's listed at. The M5 announced September 15th, 2016. That is currently at $1,249 for a kit, but that's with the 18-150 lens, so that's why it's a little pricier. It's not necessarily reflecting the fact that that camera is more expensive. It just comes with a better lens. We've got the M6, announced February 15th, 2017, so a more recent one, $799 for the kit. We've got the M10, October 13th, 2015, $599 for a kit. So at the moment, we've got those six M-series cameras. Now, I don't expect any of those probably to go away at any time, because if you look at Canon's DSLR lineup, they have a lot of older DSLRs that they are still selling, such as the T5 and the T6 and the SL1. They just tend to keep them in the lineup. I'm not even sure if they're producing them or if they're just selling off old stock, but Canon does tend to keep older options in the lineup, and perhaps just to leave a lower price point on those older ones. They still seem to sell. They keep them in the lineup. Where can we expect the M series to go? What does a mature lineup of the M series look like? Well, I'm thinking at least four cameras. We've got the M50, the newest one, and I would say that that's an 80D or 90D equivalent. We're probably going to see the 90D DSLR look a lot feature-wise like the M50, as we've recently discussed. So we're probably going to have one above that, similar to DSLRs. The 80D, we've got the 7D series in an APS-C camera above that. So we're going to have something on a 7D level. Let's call it the M7 or perhaps the M70. I'm suspecting that's going to be probably around a $1,299, $1,399 price point, and obviously with different kit lens options. That will be a higher level to the M50. It'll be like a 7D equivalent. Then we'll have our M50, which we already have. Below that, we're going to have something, I think, around an SL2 level. So something small and light but feature-packed at a really good price. Let's call that the M30. Maybe that will be an update to the M3. I suspect that'll be around $699, because when you look at the M50 at $899, you've got to have some price differentiation there. And when you look at the comparable prices between, for instance, the SL2 and the 80D, there is some price differentiation, even though the SL2 offers most of what the 80D has to offer. Below that, I suspect we'll have another camera, because they do tend to have a lot of offerings with often very little difference between them. Let's call that the T7 level in an M series. So say the M100. Let's keep the M100 in the lineup because it was recently announced. It's at $549, enough of a price point, $150 difference from, say, what the M30 we're projecting to be. So I'm saying at least four M series cameras in the APS-C lineup. Now, this is not including what may come out in full frame, but I'm not really going there yet because we haven't seen a full frame from Canon yet. It'll be interesting to expand the projected lineup with full frame. At the moment, this is where I see the M series going with APS-C bodies. These are all the offerings of APS-C, not getting into what may or may not happen in full frame because, namely, we haven't seen a full frame offering in mirrorless from Canon. So that's four. I'm looking at it from top to bottom, the M7 or M70, let's call it, something on a 7D level. The M50, we already have that. Let's say that's an 80D, 90D level, because I think it's spec pretty similarly to that. The M30, something along an SL2 line. And the M100, something along a T7 level. I would also say that it would be totally plausible knowing Canon and how they like to have a lot of offerings in the lineup, there could be one more in there. We could have five in the APS-C lineup, not including all the older stuff that will still be for sale. Because if we have four or five newer ones in a more mature lineup, we've still got five or six they're still going to be selling of the older bodies that will still probably be listed and still be available for some time. So that's where I think the M series is going, Canon's mirrorless series in APS-C. Again, I just want to make that perfectly clear. We're not talking about the development of the full frame lineup yet because we haven't even seen an offering from that from Canon. So I'm suspecting four, possibly five. I've laid out what the four I think will be in the corresponding levels. There could be a fifth in there too. I'm not sure where that might fit in, but it would be totally plausible considering how Canon usually lays out a lineup. What do you guys think? Do you agree with me? Do you think this is where the APS-C M-Series lineup is going to look as it matures? Do you think those are the levels of M-Series and comparable to DSLRs we're going to have? Do you think that I'm correct with four, or do you think the possibility of five is more correct? How many cameras do you think are going to be in the M-Series APS-C lineup? In other words, crop sensor M-Series cameras. Let me know what you guys think. Curious to hear your thoughts. How many? What's the lineup going to look like? This is just what I've been projecting and thinking on where we're going to see Canon going with this, and I'm curious to see what your thoughts are on it. Let me know in the comments below. Always great to hear your feedback. Let's flesh it out. And I guess, you know, throw in there too, what, if we don't have it already, what M-Series do you want? What's a camera in the M-Series need to be that you want? And again, let's not discuss full frame. This is APS-C. Thanks for tuning in, folks. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.